This is Laura GB, and in this video we're going to look at creating a pipeline for Power BI reports so we can move a report from development to test to production. So here we are in our report. It's a very simple report, and this version of the report is connected to my development database. I want to be able to move it into a different workspace and connect it to the test database for testing, and then when it's ready, move it into the production workspace and connect it to the production database. So we're going to start here in the report and just prepare the report ready to be able to do that. So the first thing we do is I go up to transform data, take me into Power Query. And here in Power Query, we can see our data and we can see our query that's there. And if we go back to the source step, we can see up in the formula bar there that it's connecting up to an SQL database, and I've got the name of the server and I've got the name of the database in there. If I click on the little cogwheel next to source, up comes the dialog box. And there we can see that we've got a server and things. Now what's missing is there's a little drop-down box I'm wanting next to that server and database box. So let's press cancel. Let me just show you how to turn it on. If I go to the view ribbon, there is always allow parameters. And if I tick that on, and then I go and click on the cogwheel. Now, normally I'd have it left on. So normally it will remember it for every report. And now we've got this little drop down. So I can click on the drop down. And I can say, well, I don't want it to be text. I want it to be a parameter. But first of all, I'm just going to quickly copy the value and go for new parameter. And I'm going to call this one server. Now, a really important part here, okay, is that type you need to change. Any is a bad idea. Things don't work. So we need that to be text. And the current value, paste it in. And we're going to do exactly the same thing. Let's just give a moment to catch up. There we go. We're going to do exactly the same thing for the database. So let's just quickly copy that name as well. And we're going to go for a new parameter. And let's call this one database. Now, obviously, if you've got multiple tables coming from your database, you're going to have to do this to all of the tables, but you won't have to set up the new parameter. You'll just be able to pick the parameter from the drop down. And click OK. So there we are. We've now got two parameters and our query is using those two parameters to fetch the data. So let's go and click on home and close and apply. So once the load has finished, we now need to publish our report. So I click on publish. And let's save on the way. And there we are. I've got a workspace called Customers Dev. I'm going to select that one. And if we switch across to our workspace, give it a moment to refresh. There we are. There is our report. And let's just go and do the checks that we should always do when we connect up a report. Let's go in to here and we're just going to go and check the login details. So I'm going to go to settings and I'm just going to go to data source credentials. Make sure they look okay. That looks like it's happy. Back into the workspace. It's always worth doing a can you refresh? And there we are, that refreshed successfully. So now we're ready to create a pipeline. Now a pipeline, you only create one workspace and it creates the rest. So here we are, we've created the developer workspace and we're going to create a pipeline. It has to be a premium or a premium per user workspace. So we can see mine here has got the little symbol that shows you it's a premium per user workspace. And I'm going to click create a pipeline. Asks you for a name. So I'm just going to call it customers and click create. So it's asking you, where is this one fitting? Which kind is it? So we're going to go with development and then I am going to click assign. And so there we are. We've got customers development. It's got two workspaces. It's got two items. It's got a report and a data set. And the other workspaces don't exist until you deploy to them. So let's deploy to test. And there we go. Deployment has been completed. Okay. Now, we want it that this data set is connected not to the development database, but to the test database. And I have, on exactly the same server, I have three databases set up. So I am going to come into here. There's a little settings button up here, deployment settings. So let's click that. And we are then going to go to customers. So it asks you for the data sets and asks you for what rules. Okay, so data source rules, it's not what I'm going to change. I'm going to change the parameter rules. If parameter rules are grayed out and you know you've got parameters, go back to your parameters and change them to not be any type. That was my fault that I couldn't work out for about an hour yesterday. So now under the, I can add a rule and I can choose a parameter and I'm going to go for database. And I've named them very easily. So I can take out dev and I can put in test. And then I'm going to click save. Now, the thing to understand here is these rules get applied when you deploy. So you need to deploy for these to match. And if I show you, if we go click close on there and close again, you'll see that now here you've got a symbol here that's showing amber, that means not everything matches. So if I click compare, you'll see the data sets are different. Okay, what it means is the deployment rules haven't, they don't match at the moment. But if I click deploy to test, content will be replaced, that's fine. Click continue. And now we've got the green tick because the deployment rules have been applied. Okay. And I can, if I click on show more, you can see ones here. And let's just go and check. So on this customers, I'm going to click on the three dots and go to settings. And just confirm. There you are. There you are. It's connected to test. And my credentials work okay. Now it's the first time you've connected. There's every chance you're going to have to go in there and just confirm that they're right. So if I come back into my deployment pipelines, there's my customer one, go back into there. Okay, so now I can refresh. Obviously we could go to the data set and do that, but actually it's worked fine here and I can go to show more and I can actually click on the report and see it. So let's go and have a look. And there you are. In my test database, I've got 50 customers, whereas in my development, I only had 20. Okay, so we can see our report has got different data in it we've got different things over here. So let's just go and do the final step. And let's deploy to production. And let's set up the rules in here. So click on the lightning bolt again, click on my data set, parameter rules, add a rule that my database is then my production one. Let's click save and close. Close again, deploy again, and I can refresh my report, and we can go and have a look at our report, and there you are, my production one has 500 customers. So we can see the report at different stages. If I go and have a look in workspaces, I can see that I've got three workspaces there. Your workspaces can be renamed. With regards to giving access, there is an access part here. And we can sort out our workspace permissions, so pipeline access as well. We can put in different accesses into there to give different people permissions in different places. So that was creating a very simple pipeline of taking a report from development to test to production. If you haven't already, please press subscribe. Take care now.